Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Design of Transmission Systems. And this is lecture number 5.6. We are going to solve problems in the design of spur gear. In the earlier two lectures, we discussed the design procedure for the spur gear using the PSG data book. In the previous lecture, we solved two problems in the design of spur gear. Now we continue with the problem. So here again, in this lecture, we solved two more problems from the Anna University question paper in the design of spur gear. Example number 3, the question was appearing in November 2004 question paper. Design a spur gear pair to transmit 15 kilowatt at 1440 rpm. From an electric motor to an air compressor running at 720 rpm. Take the working life as 10,000 hours. Material to be used is cast iron grade 25 for both pinion and gear. So we write down the given data. So the power is 15 kilowatt, pinion speed 1440 rpm, gear speed 720 rpm, material cast iron grade 25 and life is 10,000 hours. So first we calculate the speed ratio. Speed ratio I equal to Z2 by Z1, that is equal to pinion speed by gear speed, 1440 divided by 720 equal to 2. We choose the material for gear and pinion. It is given in the problem, cast iron grade 25, and we take the property of the cast iron grade 25 from the PSG data book, page number 1.4. The ultimate tensile strength 250 newtons per millimeter square, which is 2550 kilogram force per centimeter square, and Brillouin harness number BHN equal to 200. The torque to be transmitted by the gear MT equal to 97,420 into power in kilowatt divided by the pinion spear, 97,420 into 15 divided by 1440 equal to 1014.8 kilogram force centimeter. And we take KKD equal to 1.3. So later on for checking, we take the K value and KD value from the data book. Initially, we assume 1.3. And the design torque, MT within square bracket equal to MT into KKD equal to 1014.8 into 1.3 equal to 1319.23 kilogram force centimeter. Now we take the equivalent Young's modulus for cast iron grade 25 from the PhD data book, page number 8.14, E equal to 1.1 10 power 6 kilogram force per centimeter square. So both the pinion and the gear, they are made by cast iron. We take psi B by A equal to 0.3 initially. Then we calculate the design surface compressive stress. The equation is available in the page number 8.16. For cast iron, coefficient CB equal to 25. And Brillouin harness number is 200. Life in number of cycles. So it is given as 10,000 hours. So 60 into N into T, 60 into 1440 into 10,000 equal to 8.64 into 10 power 8. And life factor initially it is 1. So sigma C equal to CB HB into KCL. So 25 into 200 equal to 5,000 kilogram force per centimeter square. Then we calculate the center distance. The equation is available in the page number 8.13. A is greater than or equal to I plus 1 cubic root of 0.74 divided by sigma c whole square into E into design torque MT divided by I into psi. So substituting numerical values, A is greater than or equal to 2 plus 1 cubic root of 0.74 divided by 5000 whole square into 1.1 10 power 6 into 1319.23 divided by 2 into 0.3. The center distance greater than or equal to 11.26 centimeter. Then we calculate the design bending stress. So the data required for calculating design bending stress, they are available in the page number 8.19. So the endurance limit sigma minus 1 equal to 0.45 sigma u for the cast iron. So 0.45 into 2550 equal to 1147.5 kilogram force per centimeter square. Factor of safety equal to 2.0 for casting and the normalized casting. The stress concentration factor is 1.2 and life factor for bending is 1. So the design bending stress sigma b within square bracket 1.4 into KBL divided by n into K sigma into endurance limit sigma minus 1. So substituting numerical values 1.4 into 1 divided by 2 into 1.2 into 1147.5 equal to 669.375 kilogram force per centimeter square. Now we calculate the minimum module, and this equation is available in the page number 8.13a. And here we require number of teeth on the pinion. We take initially Z1 equal to 18. Form factor for Z1 equal to 18 equal to 0.0308 from the table number 40. And the psi m, B by m equal to 10. Initially we take 10. And the module, m is greater than or equal to 1.26 into cubic root of design torque divided by bending stress, design bending stress, form factor psi m into Z1, which is greater than or equal to 1.26, substituting numerical values, cubic root of 1319.23 divided by 669.375 into 0.308 into 10 into 18 equal to 0.414 centimeter. Now we take the next higher standard module from the PSC data book, table number 1, m equal to 4.5 millimeter, which is 0.45 centimeter. Now we calculate the number of teeth on the pinion. So, Z1 equal to 2A by I plus 1 into M. So, 2 into 11.26 divided by 2 plus 1 into 0.45 equal to 16.68. We take 17. So, number of teeth of the pinion is 17. And number of teeth on the gear, we calculate Z2 equal to I into Z1, 2 into 17 equal to 34. Now, we calculate the pitch circle diameter. The equations are available in the page number 8.22. PCD of pinion, D1 equal to M into Z1, 0.45 into 17 equal to 7.65 centimeter. PCD of gear, D2 equal to M into Z2, 0.45 into 34 equal to 15.3 centimeter. Center distance A equal to D1 plus D2 divided by 2, which is 7.65 plus 15.3 divided by 2 equal to 11.475 centimeter. Then face width, B equal to psi into A, 0.3 into 11.475 equal to 3.44 centimeter. And B, we have another equation, psi m into m equal to 10 into 0.45 equal to 4.5 centimeter. We have to take the highest value. So, the actual face width, B equal to 4.5 centimeter, the higher value we have to select. Then we calculate the pitch line velocity, V equal to pi dn by 60. So, pi into 0.0765 into 1440 divided by 60 equal to 5.76 meters per second. Then we take the, now we take the load concentration factor from the PSC data book, table 14, K equal to 1.03 for psi p equal to B by D1 equal to 4.5 divided by 7.65 equal to 0.59. Dynamic load factor from the table number 15, KD equal to 1.41 for IS quality 6 and velocity 5.76 meters per second. Now the design torque for the gear designed, MT equal to torque twisting moment into KKD. So 1014.8 into 1.03 into 1.41 equal to 1473.8 kilogram per centimeter. Now we check for the compressive stress. The equation is available in the page number 8.13 table 8. So, sigma c equal to 0.74 into I plus 1 divided by A into square root of I plus 1 into E into MT divided by I into B. So, substituting numerical values, 0.74 into 2 plus 1 divided by 11.475 into square root of 2 plus 1 into 1.1 into 10 power 6 into 1473.8 divided by 2 into 4.5, and this value should be less than the design compressive stress. So, the value, actual compressive stress for the gear is 4497, which is less than 5000. So, the design is safe. So, our design is safe. The next, check for the bending stress. So, again the equation is available in the page number 8.13a, table 8. Sigma b equal to I plus 1 divided by AMBY into MT design torque. And this value should be less than or equal to the design bending stress. So, substituting numerical values, 2 plus 1 divided by 11.475 into 0.45 into 4.5 into 0.302 into 1473.8. Calculating, it is 630, which is less than 669.375. So the design is safe. The actual bending stress is less than the design bending stress, so the design is safe. Now the specification of the spur gear drive for the designed gear module: 4.5 millimeter, center distance 11.475 centimeter, number of teeth on the pinion Z1 equal to 17, number of teeth on the gear Z2 equal to 34, PCD of pinion D1 equal to 7.65 centimeter, PCD of gear D2 equal to 15.3 centimeter, face width 4.5 centimeter, addendum 1 into 4.5 equal to 4.5 millimeter, redundum FO plus C into M 1 plus 0.25 into 4.5 equal to 5.625 millimeter. Tooth height addendum plus redundum equal to 4.5 plus 5.625 equal to 10.125 millimeter. And tip circle diameter of the pinion, which is pitch circle diameter plus addendum. So 7.65 plus 0.45 equal to 8.1 centimeter. And the tip circle diameter of the gear, which is PCD plus addendum, 15.3 plus 0.45 equal to 15.75 centimeter. So these are all the design specifications we have to write at the end of the problem after solving. We take another example, example number 4 from November 2010 question paper. So design a spur gear drive to transmit 22 kilowatts at 900 rpm. The speed reduction is 2.5. Material for the pinion and the wheel are C15 and cast iron grade 30 respectively. So for pinion C15 and wheel, that is gear, cast iron grade 30 respectively. Take the pressure angle 20 degree and working life of the gear as 10,000 hours. So we write down the given data. So P, power equal to 22 kilowatts. Speed N1 equal to, pinion speed equal to 900 rpm. Speed reduction I equal to 2.5. Material pinion C15 and gear CI30, cast iron grade 30, pressure angle 20 degree, life 10,000 hours. So speed ratio here it is given 2.5, and we take the material, it is also given pinion C15 and the gear C cast iron grade 30. And we take the properties of pinion material, because all the design are based on the pinion material properties. The smaller wheel is pinion, so when you design the gear for the pinion material, pinion wheel, pinion dimensions, so it will automatically satisfy the requirement of gear. So the properties of C15 from page number 1.9, the tensile strength sigma E equal to 4900 kilogram force per centimeter square, yield strength 2400 kilogram force per centimeter square, and Brinell harness number 137. Now we talk the calculate the design torque, the torque to be transmitted. MT equal to 97,420 into power in kilowatt divided by the pinion speed. 97,420 into 22 divided by 900 equal to 2381.4 kilogram force centimeter. Then we take KKD equal to 1. So we calculate, we take the K and KD value later on for checking. Initially we take KKD equal to 1.3. So design torque, MT equal to, MT within bracket equal to MT into KKD. So 2381.4 into 1.3 equal to 3095.8 kilogram force centimeter. Then we take the equivalent Young's modulus for the combination of the material. So the pinion is of C15 and gear of CI13, cast iron grade 30. From the PSG data book, table number 9, the equivalent Young's modulus E equal to 1.7 into 10 power 6 kilogram force per centimeter square. Then we take the value, psi value equal to 0.3 for our design calculation. We calculate the design compressive stress. For hardened carbon steel C15, the coefficient CR equal to 220 and Rockwell C hardness number is 60. Life and number of cycles 60 into N into T. So 60 into 900 into 10,000 hours, which is 5.4 into 10 power 8. So life factor from the PSG data book, table number 17, it is 1 for life is greater than 10 power 7 cycles. So the design compressive stress, CR into HRC into KCL, which is 220 into 60 equal to 13,200 kilogram force per centimeter square. Now we calculate the center distance from the equation. We take the equation from the page number 8.13. A is greater than or equal to I plus 1. into cubic root of 0.74 divided by design compressive stress into E into MT divided by I into psi. So, substitute in numerical values, A is greater than or equal to 2.5 plus 1 into cubic root of 0.74 divided by 13,200 whole square into 1.7 into 10 power 6 into 3095.8 divided by 2.5 into 0.3. So, the center distance should be greater than or equal to 9.81 centimeter. Then we calculate the design bending stress. The data required for design bending stress are available in the page number 8.19 and 8.20. The endurance limit 0.22 into sigma u plus sigma y plus 500. So, substituting 0.22 into 4900 into 2400 plus 500 equal to 2106 kilogram force per centimeter square. The factor of safety equal to 2 for steel and surface hardened. K sigma stress concentration factor equal to 1.5 and life factor for bending is 1. And substituting the numerical values, design bending stress sigma b within square bracket equal to 1.4 into KBL divided by n into K sigma into sigma minus 1. Substituting numerical values, 1.4 into 1 divided by 2 into 1.5 into 2106 equal to 982.8 kilogram force per centimeter square. The minimum value of the module. So, for module calculation, we require the data Z1, number of teeth and the pinion, we take initially 18, and the form factor for Z1 equal to 18 is 0.32 for full depth gear, 20 degree full depth gear. And psi m value you take initially 10, and the module, calculating the module, substituting numerical values, m is greater than or equal to 1.26 into cubic root of design torque divided by bending stress, design bending stress, form factor y, psi m and Z1. It is greater than or equal to 1.26 into cubic root of 3095.8 plus divided by 982.8 into 0.32 into 10 into 18, which is equal to 0.478. So, the standard module from the table number 1, it is 5 millimeter or 0.5 centimeter. Now, we calculate the number of teeth on the pinion. Z1 equal to 2A divided by I plus 1 into M. So, 2 into 9.81 divided by 2.5 plus 1 into 0.5 equal to 11.2, which is equal to 12. So, we require minimum teeth. So, for safe operation, we take minimum number of teeth Z1 equal to 18. So, number of teeth on the gear Z2 equal to I into Z1 equal to 2.5 into 12 equal to 0.45. Then we calculate the dimensions of the gear. PCD of pinion D1 equal to M into Z1, 0.5 into 18 equal to 9 centimeter. PCD of the gear D2 equal to M into Z2, 0.5 into 45 equal to 22.5 centimeter. And the center distance A equal to D1 plus D2 divided by 2, which is 9 plus 22.5 divided by 2 equal to 15.75 centimeter. Then we calculate the face width. So, B equal to psi into A, 0.3 into 15.75 equal to 4.725 centimeter. And the B equal to psi m into m, which is 10 into 0.5 equal to 5 centimeter. The higher value is 5 centimeter. So, we take actual face width equal to 5 centimeter. Then we calculate the pitch line velocity. So, V equal to pi D1n divided by 60, pi into 0.09 into 900 divided by 60 equal to 4.2 meters per second. Then we have to check. So, for checking, first we require K value, load concentration factor from table number 14, which is 1.06 for psi p equal to B into D1, which is 5 by 9 equal to 0.55. KD dynamic load factor from table number 15, which is 1.4 for IS quality 6 and V equal to 4.2 meters per second. Now, we calculate the design torque, MT within bracket equal to MT into KKD. 2381.1 into 1.06 into 1.4 equal to 3534 kilogram per centimeter. And now we have to check for the compressive stress. And the equation is on the table number 8. So, sigma C, compressive stress for the gear, what we have designed, 0.74 I plus 1 divided by A into square root of I plus 1 into E into MT divided by I into B. The value should be less than or equal to the design compressive stress. So, substitute numerical value is 0.74 into 2.5 plus 1 divided by 15.75 into square root of 2.5 plus 1 into 1.7 into 10 power 6 into 3534 divided by 2.5 into 5. So, calculating The design compressive stress for the gear is 6744.6, which is less than 13,200. So the actual compressive stress is less than the design compressive stress. So the design is safe. Then we have to check for the bending stress. Sigma B equal to I plus 1 divided by AM BY into design torque. It should be less than or equal to the design bending stress. Substituting numerical values, sigma B equal to 2.5 plus 1 divided by 15.75 into 0.5 into 5 into 0.32 into 3534. So the bending stress is 981.7, which is less than 982.8. So the actual bending stress is less than the design bending stress. So the design is safe. Now the specification of the spur gear drive, module 5 mm, center distance 15.75 cm, number of teeth on the pinion 18, number of teeth on the gear 45, PCD of pinion 9 cm, PCD of gear 22.5 cm, face width 5 cm, addendum 1 into 5, 5 mm, redundum FO plus E into M 1 plus 0.25 into M equal to 6.25 mm, tooth height addendum plus redundum equal to 5 plus 6.25 equal to 11.25 mm, and tip circle diameter of the pinion, pitch circle diameter plus addendum 9 plus 0.5 equal to 9.5 cm. And tip circle diameter of the gear, PCD plus addendum, 22.5 plus 0.5 equal to 23 cm. We stop here, and these are all the books I have published in mechanical engineering subject. And I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel for your better learning. So thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. And you can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again in another video lecture on the problem on spur gear.